Welcome back to MVM. Today we have a preview for a game that I promise you've probably never seen before. This one is called Cinder, based off the popular app Tinder, which I am too old to even know about.
Right. I too have very little, actually no experience with Tinder, but with Cinder we have some experience. We've played this. This is a 2-4 player game where you're going to be trying to date dragons, as the box says, without getting burned.
Which is hilarious because you aren't even a dragon yourself. You take on the form of some human or even in this...
I'm a unicorn.
Yeah, you're a unicorn named Neo of all things. Which is one of the cool draws of this game is that you're taking on a persona of the character, but you also get to kind of like personalize it to your own persona.
Yeah, you're actually filling out a dating profile, if you will, at the beginning of the game on these cards. And then hopefully matching up with a dragon as you kind of swipe through them during the game.
Yeah, so this is a push-your-luck party game in which you're trying to date a dragon by rolling dice and trying to match your attributes to that of the dragon. And it's very, very simple to play, but the game itself is a race to gain love from these dragons. And the first person to gain 21 is going to signify the end of the game.
Yeah, and what we've got here on the table here is quite simple. These are our prototype components, but there's not much to talk about. We've got the dice that you're going to be rolling when you go on the dates. The dragons here, of course, which is what you're trying to date. Then next to the dragons, you have these locations. These are kind of effectively the dates that you will be going on. And then down below here, we kind of have a game sort of set up in progress. These are dragons that may have been swiped left or have burnt you in the past that are going to go down here into the dating pool. And then here at the bottom, we have some bonus cards.
Probably the most important part of the game, though, is your persona. And you get to personalize it at the start of the game. It's going to be blank. However, you're going to be writing on it. And there's a couple things you get to write. On the left side, it has no gameplay bearing, but you get to have some fun with this.
Right.
You get to put your person's name, what gender they are, what your likes and dislikes may be. But on the right-hand side, you're going to have four different attributes, which have three different types of words associated with them. For instance, you have treasure. Are you a hoarder? Are you a spender? Are you an investor? And you're going to circle one of these in each of these areas, making sure that you have no more than two in one particular column. That is going to basically be your match with the dragons that you're going to find in the game.
Yeah, those are the important part. Like Jeremy said, you have fun with the other side. I'm a unicorn named Neo. I'll let you think about that for a second. My pronoun is it. I like rainbows, but I dislike rain.
Yeah, I like time, but I dislike zones. Makes perfect sense, right?
I like that.
So to start the game, the first player has an option. They're going to first decide which dragon they wish to date. And they're going to use that dragon deck or the app in order to date dragons. And just like Tinder, you're going to swipe left or right in order to decide which dragons you wish to date. Now, you're always allowed to go through two dragons at no cost. At the start of the game, you're just going to have the deck of cards and no cards down here. So you're going to look at that first card and you're going to read the thematic portion of the card, because this is really important to try to match up with your own personal attributes. Once you read this to the entire group, you kind of have to think to yourself, well, is this person a spender? Are they someone who is mild or relaxed? What kind of climate do they like to live in? And that's kind of the guessing game within the game itself. If you choose to use this dragon, you're going to flip it over and try to date it. If you don't like it, you're going to swipe left and put it on the furthest left area of this area.
Yeah, and whenever a card is added to the dating pool, it's going to bump that last card off, so there's always just going to be three dragons down there. It's important to remember, you can always choose a dragon from the dating pool as well as the dragon on top of the deck, even after you've swiped left. When you do swipe left, you can do that twice
for free.
But every other time you do it on one given turn is going to cost you a love point. So it's kind of nice you have those love points that are your points, of course, but it's also a currency that you can spend. Once you take a dragon, no matter how you've taken it, you're going to flip it over, like Jeremy said, and then you're going to see very specifically how it lines up with your compatibility factors.
So there's three options that happen once you decide on dating one of these dragons. You're going to look at each of these different rows and columns and determine if your attributes line up with that of the dragon. If they are the exact same attribute, such as mild on the dragon and mild on my dating app, I am going to collect a green die, which are the best dice in the game. If it is one spot away, such as relaxed and active, you're going to gain a blue dice. But if you're two spots away, you're going to gain a red die, and you're going to have four dice. These are the dice you're going to roll and attempt to date that dragon.
Yeah, the next thing you're going to do is you're going to take the location of your date. This is this deck right here. You're gonna take this and then finally flip it over to see what it has going on. These are gonna potentially have some bonuses depending on the dragon you've dated. Again, you're only going to be able to see the top of this, so the back of it's gonna really reveal the specifics of where you're going.
And remember, each of these dragons not only have their own characteristics, but they also have their own attributes at the bottom. These are things that can happen or trigger during that date itself. So you need to pay attention to that particular dragon and see if any of those triggers occur during your turn. During your turn, you get to roll the dice that you've collected for that round. So again, coming back to this example, I get one red die, one green die, one blue die, and then another red die, which isn't a great roll because I have two reds. Now, the statistics on the dice are obviously the green are the best, red are the worst. That's because you're trying to roll heart symbols, which are love. That's your ability to date that dragon. And just like other Yahtzee-style games, you're gonna roll these up to three times, trying to collect hearts. Each of the hearts that you collect each round are going to carry over into the next roll, and you're trying not to bust. And how do you bust? By rolling three flames. That's when the dragon will actually burn you. And each time that you collect one of those burn symbols, you're going to place it across the top of your player mat. Those cannot be re-rolled.
Yeah, the rolls are represented on the location card right across the top. The first roll is the meetup. If you choose to go further, it's the next step. And then finally, your third role is called taking it to the next level.
Yeah, and they all have thematic, funny, different things you're going to do, such as sitting down watching a movie, maybe having breakfast with them the next day, hint, hint. But it's up to you on how far you wish to push your luck. Remember, each one of those hearts that you roll will have to be re-rolled on your second roll, so you're just tallying those in your head. And if you ever get three, you're going to get burned. But before I get there, you're also going to notice that on some of these flames, you have spark symbols. These will trigger only if the dragon has a specific ability that's going to trigger that spark. Specifically, there's ones that say, like, on your first roll, if you roll a spark, something's going to happen during that turn. So, two outcomes can happen. You can stop, and if you stop, you're going to take all the hearts that you rolled throughout all three of the possible rolls and mark that across the bottom of your player mat. Again, this is a race to get 21 of these love points. If you bust, it depends on how many flames that you roll on that turn. If you roll one flame, you're going to take one of these cards to be able to use on the next turn. If you roll two flames on that last turn where you bust, you collect this card, and you're going to collect this if you roll three flames. However, if you're successful, you get to collect that dragon and put him to the right of your player mat.
Yeah, a successful date is going to take the next step necessarily. You can just roll once and get your love points, but then you have to give the dragon back. If you've rolled twice or three times and been successful in the end, you're gonna take that dragon beside your player mat, and it's gonna be in your dating circle. This is yet another dragon that on a future turn you can go on a date again with. So if you had a really good compatibility match with that dragon, you might wanna keep it in your circle and roll those same dice on your following turns.
And if you don't have a successful date with that dragon, it's going to go to the far left area and push the furthest right one out. Now, we mentioned previously that you're allowed to go through this app deck to be able to date dragons. There is another way in order to date dragons. You can actually steal them from your opponents. If that person has that dragon in their dating pool, meaning that they have a successful date with that dragon, of course it's going to be face up to the right of their player mat, and they could have multiple of those in front of them. If you look over there and you see a really juicy compatible dragon that you want to date that lines up with all of your particular characteristics, you can spend three love in order to steal that dragon from them and attempt to date it instead of getting one from the pool.
Yeah, it adds a nice level of interactivity when someone happens to get one of those really good dragons for them. Even if it may not be the best dragon for you, you might want to get it out of their dating circle.
And we mentioned these second chance cards. These will come into play, obviously, when you've had a bad roll. You can use these to reroll one die or multiple dice, depending upon which one of these cards that you have in front of you.
And like we've said, you're going to continue doing this around the table until someone reaches 21 love points at the end of their turn. That's going to trigger the end of the game, and then everyone who hasn't taken a turn that round is going to get to take a chance as well. Now, one thing we haven't talked about is Cinder Confidential. This is sort of a slightly advanced version of the game. You introduce these confidential cards at the beginning of the game. Everyone is going to get one, and these have a variety of different endgame scoring goals on them. When you use these, you're going to take one of the unused profile cards from the game, flip it over beside yours, and this is used to track various different things as you go on dates, successful dates typically, with the various dragons. For instance, the kind of breath weapon they have, whether or not you got burned, or whether maybe you did get burned a lot. Some of these things can trigger off if you got burned a lot. So at the end of the game, everyone's going to reveal this. use their tracking sheet to determine how many points they scored off of it.
And remember, this is a silly, fun party game that's meant to be a pseudo race game. However, everyone at the table, which I love, has the same number of turns. So if someone races the 21 and they get to that spot, you still have one last chance to be able to do so. This is going to be on Kickstarter, so make sure you guys check out the Kickstarter page for all the final components. If you have any questions about the game, make them in the comments below. Subscribe to us, follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, and everything else that we do. We'll catch you guys next time, and thanks for watching.
Bye-bye.